Welcome back to our channel, and if you're new here, we are a minimalist family of seven and we are vlogging our way through our journey of living big with less. And just on this past weekend, we went through our garage. We recently moved into a new apartment about a month ago, and that had become our catch-all for anything we thought was going to live there. We hadn't organized it at all, and it was basically chaos. Trying to get in and out of the house was just mayhem. So we have internal stairs in our apartment building, so we have our shoes down in our garage so that ourselves and our kids can put our shoes on the shoe rack, or it used to be a shoe bucket, and then come upstairs. So there was just, no one could find their shoes. There was no space to put shoes on or take shoes off. Getting bikes in and out was just crazy. So I knew that I had to change it and that I didn't want it to be that cluttered or disorganized. But I also know that there's some benefit to living in a space for a little while before you decide to organize it. So I knew exactly what I wanted this space to do. I knew what I didn't want it to be. I didn't want it to be a dumping ground. My husband and I have often noticed that lots of people have these huge garages, yet their cars sit outside because their garage is full of stuff. And you know, living a minimalist life, we would really like our car to be in the garage and not much else, and for it to be a space for us to be able to leave our shoes and all the dirt and sand, because we live across the road from the beach, to stay downstairs, making the cleaning upstairs much easier. So we took on this project. It took us a couple of hours, but we are so happy with the results. So we can't wait to show you, and I'll walk you through with some of my tips for cleaning and decluttering your garage. Check it out. So the first thing we did was to clear out all the stuff that we had in the garage and take it outside so we could start cleaning. So the stuff we have in here is mainly bikes, shoes, tools, and like moving stuff that we need to keep in the garage. Oh, and a giant TV box. Is it easy to show with the weight of the world on my shoulders? So that box that Caleb just took out, now that's our Christmas stuff. This bin that's up there, the blue bin, was actually here when we moved in, and so we had no idea what was in it. We were slightly scared that there was going to be like a dead body in it, but Caleb had a look and something. It was empty. Thank God. So here's all our stuff outside. It was like a schmozzle. We have some car cleaning stuff. There's my little boy. And yeah, the kids just had a great time playing outside while we cleaned out the garage. I wanna find a new keeper. So the first thing we did was put the TV box up. So we're going to keep this so that when we move, because it's a flat screen, we can move it back in its original box. So as you can see, I had already done like a quick sweep, and Caleb's just giving it like a bit more of a vigorous sweep because there was so much sand and dirt in here. So we live across the road from the beach. And I'll show you in a minute just like how much grossness was down here. And so because we're walking down here without our shoes on, we just wanted the floor to be really clean to put our shoes on. Here I am sweeping up the giant pile of sand and dirt and grossness. There was actually a carpet on the floor that we rolled up and took out so that we could clean all this up. And a lot of that was underneath that carpet. So after I had done a really good sweep and sweeped up all that excess dust, I actually let our robot vacuum go through the entire downstairs and on the carpet. And as you can see, it picked up so much dust and disgustingness. So this is everything back in. We also bought a deep freeze because I've only got a small freezer upstairs and it's just super handy for a family of our size. We hung as much as we could. Here is pretty much all of our shoes. There's our car in, so it's really important that we be able to use the space with the car in. All the tools and things are up on that top rack. And all the stuff that we access all the time, so the kids' bikes and scooters, the pram and the shoes are all really easy. They're either hanging up on the wall there. There's a little stepping stool for us to get to the top stuff. Here's a quick before and after. As you can see, like, everything's way more pushed back against the wall, so we've got way more room to put our shoes on. Thanks for watching.